guys. So one of the things I hear a lot about Japan is that it's really difficult to make Japanese friends. And usually I give advice like try joining a club or just make friends with one person and then you can infiltrate their friend group and make friends with all of their friends. But I recently started using an app and I found out that it's surprisingly easy to make friends with it. So I wanted to share that with you today. It's called HelloTalk. They actually contacted us and asked us if we would review their app, and I'm glad they did because I actually really like it and I think you guys are gonna find it useful. So it's a language exchange app. What it does is it matches you up with people who natively speak the language that you're trying to learn, and then you teach each other your languages. And originally I was just going to review that function, but it turned out to be so easy to make new friends with it. I joined on a Wednesday, and when you join, you create a little profile where you can put a profile picture, like your name, your location, age, the language you're learning, and how good you are at it. And you don't have to put all of that in there, by the way. Like, you don't have to put a picture of yourself. You don't have to like tell people how old you are or where you're living if you feel uncomfortable with any of that, so don't worry about that. But anyway, I did all of that on a Wednesday, and then when I checked it again on Friday, I had 30 messages from mostly Japanese people who were all saying things like, hi, let's be friends and or language exchange partners. And so, of course, I responded to every single one of them, and I was like, yay, let's be friends. And now I'm chatting with so many people that I can't even keep up with all of them, and I have plans to meet someone. So it like connected me to so many Japanese people just like right away. So how it works is you click search and then look for people to do a language exchange with through different criteria. And when you click on someone's profile, you can see what languages they speak and what languages they're learning. Some people have a bit of a self-introduction that'll say things like, I'm learning English, I really like basketball and movies, let's be friends. Or some people will say things like, I'm only looking for serious language partners. And from here, you can write out add them as a language partner, which they have to approve, or you can message them. So far, I haven't even had to message anyone because so many people have sent me messages first. One thing I was a little worried about was that people might use it as like a dating or a hookup app, but at several points throughout like learning how to use the app, there have been little pop-up messages that'll come up and say things like, this is not a dating app, please don't use it like this, or if someone sends you inappropriate photos, please report them, and things like that. So I was glad to know that they take a proactive approach in trying to prevent things like that. So far, I haven't really had any problems like that, but I have had some people who I've been messaging and they'll say things like, you're cute, and stuff like that. But I think if you put like maybe a picture of your cat as your profile picture or something, then you're probably not gonna get messages like that. Another option is there's a setting where you can say like, I only want to be able to talk to people of the same gender as me, or I only want to be able to talk to people within a certain age range. So you can kind of prevent stuff like that too if you're worried about it. And in the worst case scenario, you can always block someone. Obviously, in the end, you're still talking to strangers through the internet, so you should be a little bit careful. But so far, I've just been having good experiences with it, so I definitely think it's worth checking out. Moving on to the actual purpose of the app, it's for finding language exchange partners. There are a lot of options for when you talk to someone. You can send pictures, call them for free, and request language exchanges. They even link to tutorials in the app for you to show you how you can use like the language exchange function. And I think that language exchange function is really useful because so far most of the people I've been talking to, we either talk primarily in English or we talk primarily in Japanese, and there's not actually much like actual language exchange going on. So if you use the language exchange function, then it forces you to speak half of the time in Japanese and half of the time in English, in my case, because those are the two languages I'm doing. When you click on someone's message, there are also a lot of options. You can correct their sentences if they're writing in your language, or you can translate or transliterate their text. It's not perfect, but it has been helpful for me when I have seen like kanji that I didn't recognize. I'll transliterate it, and then usually when I see the spelling of it, then I'm able to recognize the word. For voice messages, there's also an option to transcribe those too. And when you're texting someone, you can send a translation with it automatically. Since the translation isn't perfect, you can erase the machine translation and then do your best to translate it yourself, and then the person who reads it can correct it for you. You can also do group chats as well. And all of that stuff is free. You don't have to pay for any of it. There are limits to some things, like how many times you can use the translation button, but you can get a pro membership and that gets rid of all of the limits and gives you a couple other functions as well. Or you can also pay each month to add an extra language to your profile. So instead of just being able to search for and talk to people who speak Japanese, you'll also be able to search for and speak to people who speak Spanish, for example. So far, I've mostly just been using this app to chat with people and practice my Japanese and help correct other people's English, but I like it a lot. And I think it's really useful for people like me because all I'm pretty much doing is texting people. So I can do this when I'm like waiting on a train or in a car or standing in line or something. So for people like me who are super busy and don't necessarily have time to sit down and open a book and study every day, then this is really convenient because all I have to do is just like take out my phone and text someone and I can practice my Japanese. If you are a native Japanese speaker, by the way, and you're learning English, feel free to send me a message and chat with me. I'm more than happy to be friends with people and do language exchanges and stuff. I don't have a lot of time to respond to people like every single day, so I might not be able to respond very quickly and stuff, but I love making new friends and chatting with people. So my actual ID on this is @Rachel376. So feel free to send me messages sometime. But this is only for language exchanges. If you just want to chat, then we can talk on Twitter or something like that. To find this app, the website is hellotalk.com, or we link to it down in the description bar, or you can search for HelloTalk in the Google Play or App Store. I like this app a lot, so I hope you guys will find it useful too. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys later. Bye!
We're gonna measure our heads. You're 58 and a half. I'm sorry.
No, I'm not embarrassed at all. I don't care.